Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and...
This is Pahimar. Duh!
How are you, sir?
I'm good, how are you, sir?
What are we doing?
We are in a hut, and it's a rainstorm, so I would think that we're at Forgecraft, but I hear we're not.
We are not. We're playing Agrarian Skies. Did you see that I actually posted, like, a thing about whether or not I should do Agrarian Skies, Pahimar?
I did, and it seemed like it was very one-sided.
It was pretty one-sided. I want to say 85% of people said, yes, do the map. 9% of people said, do whatever you want, we don't care. And, like, 6% of people were like, no, don't do it. So I felt like that was pretty overwhelmingly in the majority of, we should do Agrarian Skies. So I decided to do it, and I was telling Pahimar about it, and he's like, let's co-op. And I said, oh, that would be good, because I'm all about that. That sounds like a fun time.
Yeah, the last time we did a map, like a Skyblock map, was back in the days of Feed the Beast 125, when they first had their multiplayer map.
I know. That was fun. That was a long time ago. Oh, man.
Jinx.
I got so many books going on here.
I only have one because I died when I started up the server.
Oh, well, that's unfortunate. Well, you don't really need any of them.
I have the important
one. There's nothing interesting. So here's the deal, guys. Not only are we playing Agrarian Skies, but we have an alpha version of the questing mod, the hardcore questing mod, that Pahimar and I can use that's going to help us out with our little co-op adventure here. You ready to check this out, Pahimar?
I am born ready.
This is an alpha, so it might break, but we'll see. They added co-op abilities to the questing book. So what we can actually do now is you'll see here that there is a party section. So I'm going to open the party window, and I'm going to create a party. Let's name it... What do you want to name the party, Pahimar?
I think Dire Skies is a pretty good name.
I was going to go with Dire Pahi Party.
Well, that's a good one, too.
All right, now if you open your book, if you already have it open, you have to close it and reopen it. That's a bug that they're going to fix. But you should see the party window. And you
Yeah, I
see
party. You have one party invite. Click here to open party window.
Yeah, do that.
Ooh, I have been invited to the Dire Pahi Party.
Dire Pahi Party.
And I will accept it. And now we are in a Dire Pahi Party.
I'm in a team with two players. Hooray! Ooh. This is alpha, so it's not even close to done, but, like, they wanted a lot more stuff in here, but when I was telling BSWE, like, can we have, like, an early copy? He hooked us up. So, what this means, Pahimar, is that when we turn in quests, look, it combines our lives. We each had 4 lives, now we have a total of 8. So if you die a lot, I'm in trouble.
Yeah, we decided, because we kind of don't want the series to end early because we're both not very good at this, we decided to start with 4 lives as opposed to 2, and we have a little insurance policy on the back of the house.
We do. In case of derp, break glass. So there's some extra hearts in there. So those of you who didn't watch the video about how this map works, basically it's a hardcore map, but instead of just having 1 life, you have a set number of lives. And some of the quest rewards from the quests that we're going to be doing will give us extra lives. So we start out right now, between the two of us, we can die 8 times total. So, you know, we're pretty probably going to be all right, I think. I'm feeling better now that we both have 8 lives. So there's a lot of quests here that we have to go through. We wanted to make sure that when we were doing the video series together, because I'm posting it on my channel and Pahimar is posting on his YouTube channel, that, like, it's not one-sided and, like, I'm doing all the quest hand-ins and his viewers don't get to see the book and see, like, the progress through it. So now what's going to happen is, like, as we progress through the book and do the individual quests, what we should see is that, like, each of us complete the quest combined. So do you want to go through, like, the basic beginner quest thing on the right there, Pahimar, and we can
book is a good one because it's one of the best ways to get some early lives.
Alright, cool. So let's go through using the book. So I've been through it. Oh, we get a pick now as a reward. That's new.
Oh, that is new.
That's a new one, yeah. Alright, so we have to craft a piece of oak wood plank. So I assume what we need to do...
Now I have... Yeah, and I know an Easter egg. You want me to show you too?
Oh, I do.
Come with me.
Okay. Following Pahimar.
You see this dirt block?
Yeah.
Break it.
Really? Ooh, look at that. More dirt.
Would that happen to be the patented CVW Dirt Chest 9000?
It is the Dirt Chest 9000.
And does it have extra pieces of dirt in it so we can expand our tree farm early?
It does. I like that news.
It is
a
fun
Easter
egg. You
know what else I want to do early?
Rain muffler?
I want to install this rain muffler.
Reading your mind.
That sounds better, doesn't it? Oh, that is so much better.
Oh, nice.
All right. Well, let's at least get our first sapling grown. Can I use the bone meal, or is that a bad idea?
Use the bone. Yeah, just go for it.
I say as I'm using it.
All right, you do the wood, I'll do the leaves.
Okay.
At least, yeah, we should actually get ourselves a crook really quickly. Leave one log, then.
I'll leave
a crook.
You know what else I heard we should do? We should not jump, because hunger is extremely challenging in this map.
I've been told that we want to make a lot of toast, but we'll get to that later.
Okay. Okay, so to craft a wood plank is our objective, so I'm going to craft one now, and there we go. So my objective is complete. What's your quest book say, Pahimar?
I now see it's complete, so we can claim the reward. Why don't I claim the reward since you did the objective so we can show this works?
I already claimed it. See if you can claim it as well.
I did? Looks like that could be a bug.
No, I think he said that's intentional. Like, we get the rewards. Yeah.
Pick of Splintered Dreams.
Yeah, that works for me. So, do you want to do the manual completion quest?
Let's see. So, if we go back.
Or do you want me to do it?
And so now
I'll give you some wood.
Okay.
So, you have to hand that in. So what Pahimar is going to do is he's going to open the book here and hit manually submit, and it'll, instead of just seeing that you got wood, it'll actually take the wood out of your inventory and place it in the book and use it to complete the quest. So go ahead and do
that. I've completed the quest, so you should now see that we have rewards.
Okay, so you claim your reward. I want to make sure my book's closed.
I have claimed my reward.
And I, too, have claimed my reward. Cool. I think it is intended that we can each claim a reward.
That's very nice. That will definitely speed us up.
Yeah, that'll help a lot.
So, let's see. Now the remaining one is the QDS.
Also, I believe that's going to be a config option in a future version. All right, do you want me to do the QDS?
Go for it.
All right, so for that, what I have to do is open the book, select the QDS task. So I'm going to hit select task here. And then I right-click on the QDS with that task. And we'll see that we have to feed one oak wood plank by a hopper into the QDS. So let's see how well this works. Dun 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 dun! I think it worked.
And now we
and
have
I
no
see
help
completion.
Given.
Cool. Okay, yes, we have no help given next. All right, so now we have to get our thing here.
I have a hopper I can just toss in.
Okay, you can do that. Go for it. Did you select the task first?
I don't believe I did.
Ah, Pahi noob.
Indeed.
That's okay. We're not supposed to be allowed to keep the hopper anyway, so I'll just break it and manually submit it. Okay, we should be good.
You know what? When I first played this, I messed this one up as well.
Did you?
We have an extra life and a bag of goodies.
Hooray! Go ahead and use your life. I'm curious. I want to see that it updates.
Ding.
Yep, 9 lives, and I'm going to use my life. Cool. So, yeah, overall, we have 10 total lives. But, you know, like, that's where it really is good, is that we have 10 lives, right? Because it would be really bad if we only got one heart from that, because, and if we didn't share lives.
So, I'm kind of want to open up this reward bag. What do you have in yours?
Oh, yeah, let's do that. I'm going to open mine and see if it... I'm sure it's going to be... It's a basic reward bag. So knowing Jaded Cat, who built this map... well, Morvi built the actual map, but Jaded built the quest rules and all that stuff. I'm going to assume this is going to be terrible.
Right.
Ooh, I got a boat with the Feather Falling 3 enchant.
Ooh, I have something you're going to love.
Oh, what? Oh, really? Wow. Mysterious Magnet level 8. That is cool. That's actually a really good thing to have.
Indeed.
And it actually works. That's surprising. I would expect her to like give us this and then have it like be broken and not work or something.
That's going to be very handy in early tree farming.
Yeah, I think so. All right, so that's the first stage of the quest. What should we do next? Should we just start with learning the Skyblock? Is that the place to go?
I think that's the best place. From what I saw, it's really good to get ourselves a collagen early on so we can start getting mob stuff. Because once we start getting a lot of bone meal, that's pretty helpful.
Okay. So go with the flow, I think, is mostly about liquids. And for the hoarding is mostly about collecting a lot of different things. Like large amounts of stuff. And then the other four quests are locked at the moment, so we can't get to those until we complete other quests. So let's start off with in the beginning. What do you say?
I say let's do it.
All right, so these are the parts where we should actually read what the quest things say. You may have noticed you start with nothing, almost no land, no food, but hey, you have a floor. Be thankful for that much. Now it is up to you to rebuild the entire planet, or as much as you can before dying. To start with, I suggest growing some trees. Oaks will supply you with apples, and the saplings, leaves, and string you will be turning into dirt. Place 3 barrels outside where rain can fall into them. Place the other 2 undercover to create a composting area. Once you have 8 spare saplings, place them in the barrel to compost into dirt. Oh, okay, that's cool. You can compost leaves, rotten meat, apples, wheat, and string. Use any eye to look up the recipes. Cool. All right, so we should build all these things that it wants us to make, right?
Yeah, so I think the first thing we want to do is we want to get ourselves a crafting bench, I believe is the proper term. And then we want to get ourselves a crook so we can start getting more saplings and we can really get going on this.
All right, well, my crafting bench is crafted.
Perfect. And
that gives us 100% in that. Nice.
Do you happen to have a plank that I can borrow and I'll make a crook?
Sure. Can I also make a crook?
Well, if you have enough planks for it.
That doesn't look too hard to make. So what's the crook do usually?
So the crook gives you a better chance of getting saplings from leaves.
Oh, well, that's going to be useful. I'm going to put on my magnet.
Your magnet? Our magnet.
Yeah, our magnet. Should I use the crook for wood as well or no?
No, you want to use an axe for that.
Okay.
And we have one of the first things we're going to need for food. I have a silkworm.
Oh, yeah. Oh, nice. So that's added by X Nilo, is that correct? The silkworm thing?
Yes, X Nilo.
Cool. So silkworms come from saplings, right? Or come from leaves.
Yeah, they come from leaves. And we'll want to plant them in leaves so we can start filling a tree with silkworms so that we can get string.
Okay. Which we can then use to get food somehow.
Yep, we can use string for beds. That's another good one to do. And then we can use string to get our first fishing rod so we can actually start fishing.
Cool.
String's also good to compost into dirt.
Yeah, I haven't played with X Nilo. There's actually a few mods in this pack that I haven't really played with before, so I'm not too sure how it works. If you want to, Pahimar, do you want to do the bone mealing and the growing of trees, or do you want to do some of the quest objectives that we can complete right now?
I can farm some trees. What we should probably do is we should also probably start getting a platform where we can do a few more saplings so that we can do it more quickly.
Okay. So I'm planting down a chest here to store stuff because that's also an objective that we've got. And we also have to get some of the Tinker's Construct stuff and some oak barrels. How do we get oak barrels? That's Java's better barrel. Oak barrel from... Okay. So we need to collect some rainwater, right? So I'll get at least 1 oak barrel going for that purpose.
I would recommend 3 for collecting water.
That's what it said, but I don't have enough wood at the moment.
Give me a sec.
Okay. How about over here? Sound like a good spot to collect water and compost? We'll just do it on the one side of our house?
Sure.
Okay.
Now the one thing I've learned is the blocks that we're standing on aren't level where normal blocks would be. So keep that in mind when you're putting down. I'm assuming you're probably going to put down slabs to grow things out.
Well, I'm placing down some dirt over here so we can get some trees going.
It's a good thing we got that magnet so we can get that dirt back.
Yeah? You don't like it being there?
Come on, man. You know Skyblock. You never put the dirt above the void.
Why not? I've got some magnet, I'm okay.
Yeah, well, it's because we got the magnet. Dire is in a whole new world of risk here.
You know what else I heard is a good plan to go with? You ready for this? This is a good move right here. Check this out.
Oh, stairs.
Yeah, that's what's up. Except this golden lantern here doesn't want to appreciate the fact that we have stairs and let us walk through it.
Ooh, one of the things we're going to have to be careful of is right now there's a good chunk of the platform that is not lit up.
Yes, that's true. Do you think it's a good idea for me to move this golden lantern? I think I do.
Should be okay because I'm standing here. Now there's actually spots on the roof of the house that aren't lit up all the way.
That doesn't work either.
I give you three logs. That should be all right, well, oh, you're stealing my wood.
I am.
You and that magnet.
Yeah. Alright, well this is supposedly better for us so that we don't have to jump to get up these blocks.
Oh, and you got the saplings too.
Cool.
Could I have some?
Alright, do you want to give me the silkworms? I'll get them started.
You gotta turn the magnet off.
I did.
Oh, they just were delayed showing up my inventory.
Okay. So I just plant a tree, right? So let me have one more sapling back there.
Whoa.
Nice. And what I'll do is I'll get this growing. Do you want me to do it maybe... Let's see. Where would be a good place to do this?
To do more trees?
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of doing it over here. Like close to where you got the barrels?
Okay.
What I can do is make some wood slabs.
Yeah. I'll get some wood slabs so we can expand. How's that sound?
Sounds lovely.
So that's a lot of wood slabs. Oh, here's another tip, Pahimar, that I learned while testing this in single player a little bit.
What was that?
Here's a very, very important tip for you.
Don't die?
Some of these blocks are micro blocks, and micro blocks do not respect the hold shift and not fall off thing. So, yeah, keep that in mind.
Mind kept.
So don't think just because you're holding shift that you're okay, because you're not.
Have you met our friend, the roadblock over there, too?
Yeah, I saw the roadblock, and I tried the roadblock, and I did not like the roadblock. I tried it in single player as well. And I'm like, wow, you're a jerk.
You tried it in both?
No, just single player.
I tried it, but I faced the house first.
There we go. Okay, I've got a tree farm over here. And I'm being very careful with my skyblock lives. Luckily, it looks like we get a quarter life from completing this objective.
If you want to swing by here, there's an apple I can't get. It's hanging on top of the arch.
Okay, I got it. That's actually pretty good, the fact that we have some apples now.
Indeed.
If you want to toss me a few more pieces of wood, I should be able to manage. Cool. So I just right click these on the leaves, right? Oh yeah, look at that. It changes their color.
And you just need one per tree. They spread pretty quickly.
Too late. Too late.
I once did, when I was trying this out for the first time, I did it on one of these giant oak trees, like when I'm cutting down right now. I was swimming in worms at the end of it. Wow, that was not a very nice sentence.
No, that's a terrible
sentence. No one likes to swim with worms. Kids, don't swim with worms.
No. Part builder, tool station, and stencil table. So I should be able to complete this objective right now, I think.
Ooh, let me know when you do.
All There's Tool Station, and I got Materials and You by Skyla, which I'll put in the chest for you so you can read. Because how much do you know Tinker's... You just started learning Tinker's Construct, right?
Yeah, I've got decent understanding now. So we just need the stencil table, is that it?
Yeah, which I'm getting right now. I think I remember the recipe for that. I think it's just that. Yes.
Here, so we should be complete, sir. Saplings in a barrel to get into dirt. That won't take long.
Okay. Oh yeah, look at that. They do spread pretty quickly, these little silkworm things. Infested leaves, nice. How many saplings did you put in that barrel?
It takes 8 saplings.
It said it had to be under, like, under your roof or something.
If there's stuff in it when it rains, it won't fill up with water. But if it's empty and it rains, it will fill up with water.
Oh, okay. I'll get a few more of those water.
Yeah, we're actually going to want quite a lot of barrels. I found that 3 water barrels work well, and then something like 8 earth for dirt. Because we're going to want to start sifting later on. Have you gotten to that, stage before?
No. Oh, look, there's dirt in there already.
Yeah, it really doesn't take any time at all. So watch. All
right. Cool. I'm actually going to... Let's put the dirt, like, underneath the roof of the house.
Why don't we put it under our emergency chest?
Well, we can't because there's all these micro blocks here.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
We have to find a spot that's, like, well-shaded, but also... I guess we could... You know what we could do? We could put it on the house. Like that.
That works.
Is that cool? I also have 7 more pieces of dirt if you want them.
No, I'm good. I'm just cutting these down. And once you get the farm over on the side all set up, then I'll move over there.
Okay. So I've got the crook. Should I start chopping down the leaves that have the silkworms on them?
That would be... wait till the entire tree's white.
Okay. I guess this, like, very white is complete then?
Yeah. Ooh, I got some seeds. In my reward bag, I got blackberry seeds, I have corn seeds, and I have lettuce seeds.
You're winning all the things.
Yep, and did you by chance pick the Pan of Destiny?
I haven't picked the reward yet.
You're gonna... let's see, I have the pan. The pan is good because it's one of the first ways you can cook things. So do you happen to have any extra silkworms on you?
I do not.
Okay, try getting one or two off that tree over there, and I'll show you how we can cook them.
Okay. So I should crook this, right? Yep. I got some string.
Yeah, you should get string, and occasionally you'll get a silkworm. As long as we have one white leaf on here, it'll still spread. Not having much luck?
No, not at the moment. I'll let more white things occur.
Okay, well I can show you this anyways.
Okay.
So, it's normally a weapon, but when you shift-click and point at the ground, you actually put the pan down.
Sweet.
And then you can put fuel in, and then there's 8 slots for input. You actually only want to do 7, and NEI just
I think you're accidentally cheating.
Yeah, I saw that. NEI accidentally gave me 54 oak, so I need to fix that. But yeah, you put your food in there, it'll cook it up.
Nice. So, since you got the frying pan, should I get the axe then?
We could go either or. The frying pan's nice because it's got knockback, which is really helpful early on.
Hmm. But the axe probably has good damage and can chop down trees better.
Yeah, but we'll be able to make flint axes very soon now that we have the Tinker's Construct stuff.
That's true.
I've been told that the pan is the superior.
Okay. Well, I'm just thinking because we can both do it, but I'll get another pan.
Yeah, I think you stole my pan.
Did I?
Yeah, magnet.
I did. That's awesome. All right,
Turn your magnet off!
All right, stop breaking things.
Stop stealing things.
I'm going to claim the pan as my reward.
I'm going to start calling you Klepto Wolf.
Thank you. And I'm going to put this heart thing that I got in the chest here. We should be super conservatively, like, when we get hearts, we should put them in the chest immediately until we use them. Oh, what's the config setting, by the way, for, I got another pickaxe. Writing pick. Writable. Stonebound. Thaumic. Mining level. Stone. Skill level.
Ooh, was that your reward?
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah, not bad. I'll put some string in here. So I can cook up this this here silkworm. Just one?
Yep. That's a good example of it. Cool. Ooh, it's blowy tonight.
Alright. Neat. Oh, there's a progress bar up there. I see. Okay.
Yeah, it's not exactly where you'd expect the progress bar, but I'm not going to complain. No. It's food.
Yeah, I'll take it. I also have 10 apples at the moment, so I feel like we're doing pretty well with food.
Yeah, 10 apples was actually one of the reward for the Tinker's Construct stuff we just did.
Oh, right. Well, I have 4 on top of that, so 14 total.
Yeah, I've got 12, so we have quite a lot of apples. But apples, basic food actually doesn't give us a lot of hunger back. I think, like, one apple only gives you, like, half a hunger back. That's why we want to make meals. So that's why when I said we were going to want toast, because toast is made from bread, which is made from wheat, so it's more complex. So apparently we feel fuller longer.
Okay. I have a cooked silkworm then.
So if you're hungry, why don't you go ahead and munch on that?
I'm actually not. My hunger bar is still very full.
Yeah, we're lucking out so far in that regard.
Yeah, I think we're doing well. Now we just have to make it rain. Oh, look, the tree is pretty much all white.
What we should do is we also should get a bed going soon so we can set our spawns. Because right now my spawn is in this, you can't see it, but my viewers can see it. They can see this hologram light beam off in the distance where I died originally.
Oh, yeah, because when you spawned on the server, you died instantly, right?
Yeah, I think that Mervlyra is working on a multiplayer version of the map where each player spawns on their own unique platform. So then people wouldn't do what I did and die.
Sometimes when I tap on these leaves, they're turning back to green.
That is a visual bug. I asked them about that as well. So that's something that they know about. They want to get it fixed.
Oh, okay, cool. Oh, yeah, we're getting lots of string now.
Yeah, silkworm trees actually produce a ton of stuff. You know, this is totally reminding me of the Feed the Beast Ultimate multiplayer map we did. Because in that one, because we were live streaming that, I think that one was for charity. I did tree cutting down for like 6 hours.
Really?
Yeah, don't you remember that? You guys were doing all the cool stuff, and I was climbing up jungle trees to cut them down.
Oh yeah, I do kind of remember that.
Yeah, Elram was helping us with that map. That was a good time. That was like a weekend.
That was a long map.
That was meant to be a long map. Well, it was... If you took bees out of it, it wasn't going to be so long.
Yeah. Are there bees in this map?
I don't know, but I think there might be.
I need a sapling, by the way, if you can toss me one.
There you go.
Thank you.
There you go.
This magnet is very useful.
I know. I'm still trying to figure out how I got it, and now you use it.
Well,
it's like it's drawn
to
you. I wanted to show you, but I think it found you as a new owner.
Well, you can have it back if you want.
Nah, I'm good for right now. Does it work in chests?
In chests? No.
Oh, that'd be cool. That'd be like a black hole band.
Yeah, that would be neat. Alright, so do you want to...
Now I'm getting a ton of viewer comments asking about black hole band.
Yeah, well, you walked into that one, buddy.
Hey, you know what? I got cool plans for that thing, so people don't need to worry.
Okay, good. Because I was worried.
No, I know you like your black hole band. Same as you're still going to get your boots at the Direwolf.
Yay! So our next goal is smooth as silk. We need a bunch of things. String is the gateway to all resources. Fishing rods will provide food. Oh, that's true. Sieves are used to sift dirt, gravel, sand, and dust to obtain stone, ores, and other resources. To get string, you will need to break leaves with your crook until you receive a silkworm, which we did already. Right-click a leaf block on a newly grown tree with the silkworm. Walk away when all the leaves on the tree have turned white. Break them with a crook to get string and more silkworms. Cool. When you have enough... have extra silkworms, you can cook them for food. Oh, nice. Oh, and then we get a stone axe for this reward, so... And we get a bunch of seeds, too. Alright, so do you want me to start working on this stuff that we have to get?
Sure.
Okay. So you did say you want a bed. That's one of the objectives.
Beds are very helpful here.
I can only imagine.
Oh, have you... I don't recall this in your spotlight, but did you see what happens when you run out of hunger entirely?
I did not.
You instantly die.
Oh, nice. That's good to know.
So it's not like the slow tick down where you can rush back to your chest. You will die immediately. Man, there's so much wood up there.
I got a fishing rod so we can fish.
Now, I've actually found that this map is particularly challenging to fish on. So let me get this lumber here, and I'll show you a technique that I learned from Cloudy. The problem is we don't have a lot of source blocks right now, but there's a lot of flowing blocks, so the bobber gets caught.
What if we just, like, come over here and place a piece of dirt in this area so that...
For some reason, it still gets caught. I think it's the multi-block, the micro-blocks, I should say.
Okay. Well, these are actually full blocks around this lake. We should build a fish in this lake here. I'm going to try that. My trick is to, if you aim straight up, it'll fall straight down.
Ah, you've learned the Cloudy trick.
Is that a Cloudy trick?
That's how Cloudy managed to fish.
Okay, cool. All right, Bobber. Bob.
Yeah, you do the fishing, because I'm not good at fishing.
I hate fishing.
Here in 1.7, fishing's much more rewarding.
Yeah, but it's still as painful.
Yeah, and I'm now thinking, too, that because in 1.7 there's many more types of fish, you know that Sengir is now going to add fish breeding.
Oh, God, no, please. Make it
because
not so.
Bees, trees, and butterflies were not enough.
No. Can butterflies be bred yet? I don't think they can be yet. Yeah, the straight up and down thing works perfectly, by the way.
Well, you get us a lot.
No.
Okay.
I'm not a fan of fishing. It's very boring.
I hear fishing is supposed to be relaxing.
Yeah, it stresses me out. F7 helps a lot in this map, by the way.
That it does. I'm going to sleep and set my spawn.
Okay. That's cool with me. I'm going to get another crook. And I'm going to go get some more silk worm stuff. Well, they're not quite done spreading yet. I'll give them some more time.
Yeah, I'm doing some more dirt here.
Okay, how about this? We will be back in a few minutes, YouTube, once we're got more interesting things to do. Because I think at this point, we just have a little bit of grinding to do. You know what? I guess what I could do before we wrap up this segment is get this tool station and stencil table going. So you're on board with the whole stencil table and how that works and everything now?
Yep, I'm on board with that.
Cool. So I don't have to train you on that. So tool station, stencil table. So apparently we need to make a hammer. A wooden hammer, but a hammer nonetheless.
Do you have oak saplings, by the way?
I have 7, yes.
Could I have one?
Sure. Can I have some more wood?
If you turn off your magnet.
Oh. Those are all my oak saplings, by the way.
I will be very cautious with them.
Okay. So, in order to get a... It wanted me to get a hammer? Is that true? Wooden hammer.
Oh, yes. The wooden hammer is very important. Especially at this stage.
Oh, you know what? That's an ex-Nihilo wooden hammer. That's not a Tinker's wooden hammer. Okay. Alright, so now we just need a little bit more string from these silkworms, and then we should be able to progress this quest.
Okay, why don't we take a break, and you do that, and we'll come back.
Okay. Alright guys, we're back, and I think we have the resources to do this next hand-in, but at the same time, I think it's also about time to wrap up our first episode here, Pahimar, because I think we're getting pretty close to long in the tooth for this one.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing how quickly we get through to that point.
Yeah, I know. So let's see, I need to make an oak sieve, or sieve, or whatever you want to call that.
Oak sieve.
That's the word I'm looking for, so sticks, oak wood planks, and silk mesh. So I got enough silk from our tree, and our crafting table here is a little bit buggy. I don't know what's up with that. But, okay. Oh, I have cooked silkworm on my thingy. Alright, so I should be able to do this. There we go. Oak sieve.
Nice.
Nice.
Okay, so that says we can do something cool with that. Should this be outside or inside?
Let's do that outside.
Okay.
And over I actually here again, have or? Some blocks we can use for that.
Cool.
Sure.
Sure.
How about there? That looks like a good spot.
Yep. Have you ever used one of these before?
Yeah. I have not. X Nihilo is a mod I haven't really used much.
So you get your dirt from these oak barrels from composting.
Okay.
Then you stick one in the sieve and just right click on that.
Oh, that's neat. I like the little particle effects dropping out. Whoa!
And you get not drops. Everywhere. So you probably got four stone things, and it looks like you got some seeds out of that.
Yeah, I like it.
So four of those stone drop-like things.
Oh, makes cobblestone.
Yeah, I'm going to do one myself now.
Cool.
Oh, it's just called stone. So you got seeds, I just got four stone.
Okay, so let's complete this next quest. So what reward do you want to pick, and what reward do you want me to pick? Because we should pick different rewards. Our options are seeds, carrots, and cotton.
Well, we just got seeds from your drop, so we've got that. Cotton and sugar cane I've seen drop from other things, so we probably want carrot seeds. Carrots are an excellent source of food in this map.
All right, you get carrot seeds. Which one should I pick then? Because
I think sugar cane, because we can get, because cotton seed gives you cotton, and we have, it's raining.
Nice, so we should be collecting water in this stuff now? Look at that.
Skeleton.
Skeleton. Nice.
Oh, I missed it.
What? Oh, he dropped something.
Oh, he dropped some stuff. We got company dire.
Should we sleep through the night?
We only have one bed.
Is Morpheus on here? Apparently not. So we need another bed? I don't have the resources to make another bed.
Let's go to battle.
I got some arrows.
And we appear to be monster free. Yay!
Hooray! Alright, so I think we do have to wrap up the episode here, guys. But what we'll do is Pahimar and I will start messing around with some of the stuff. All right, so I'm claiming sugarcane as a reward then?
Yeah, and I will take carrot seeds.
All right. And we should each have a nice little stone axe with Bane of Arthropods on it, which is kind of nice. And we should also start having cobblestone. Hooray. So, in fact, you want to give me your quarter heart? We should have enough to get a full heart now.
In the chest.
Thank you, sir. Nice. Alright, we should have an extra life. Alright, guys, so for now, this is Direwolf20 signing off. And Pahimar too, I presume?
Yep, Pahimar signing off.
Cool. We'll be back next time to mess around some more in Agrarian Skies. Hope you enjoyed this episode. Do me a favor, guys. Leave me some feedback on the episode. Obviously, it's a different style of episode that I'm used to doing. Now, because we had a lot going on, there weren't many cuts here, but we'll probably be doing more cuts, in the future. Look at that. We do have a lot of water filling up in these barrels. Do I need to make another barrel? Probably.
Probably.
All right, guys. Probably. Yeah, so leave me a comment on the episode. Let me know if you liked it and all that good stuff. And we'll catch you next time. All right, everybody. Take it easy.